The 9F is quite a large loco, but once we open it up we can see there's not a lot of space to fit a quality sound system in. There's an area at the front ideal for a sound decoder board, and at the rear there is space for a Stay Alive capacitor, but there's not much room left to put in a decent sized speaker. So I have also taken apart the tender, and I think with a bit of surgery we can get a quality speaker in here which should give us a good sound output. So we'll make a start and see how we get on. The sound system is now connected up in the 9F, including a large Stay Alive capacitor fitted at the rear. One of the things I want to do with this installation is to test a couple of quality speakers to try and find one which would fit in the tender of most British outline locomotives and provide a good quality sound. To this end, I ordered two speakers to try with this installation. The first one is a baby boomer speaker which is connected, so we'll now have a listen to that and see what that sounds like. The second speaker I bought is an ice cube speaker, so we'll now fit the ice cube speaker in and have a comparison test. The ice cube speaker sounds much clearer and sharper to me, but I'll have a look at the recordings where I can see the audio levels and just double check the results. The ice cube speaker did show to be the best for a steam sound loco with the higher frequencies involved. The boomer speaker is probably more suitable to a diesel type engine. So we reassembled the body of the loco, drilling a hole at the back of the cab to bring out the speaker wires. Drilled holes in the bottom of the tender chassis to allow the sound output, as it's otherwise a very tight fit soundproof box. and the speaker turned out to be a perfect fit in the tender. So we'll now go ahead and reassemble the Loco and have a look at it when it's finished.